local motorists are not satisfied with this week's oil price rollback. A senator is also slamming the temporary suspension of the government's fuel subsidy program due to the COMELEC spending ban. Jackie Manabat reports.
For the second time this year, oil firms are rolling back fuel prices in the Philippines after imported oil prices eased last week in the international market. The price slash for gasoline will be 2 pesos and 30 centavos per liter, 185 for diesel and 165 for kerosene. But some motorists are not satisfied.
Niloloko lang tayo ng ano eh, mag-rollback na piso tapos magdadagdag na 5 piso. Sobra-sobra yung dagdag, dapat bawasan nila yung dagdag.
Wala rin kwenta yung rollback na yan. 70 lang din mangyayari. Dapat eh, ibalik yung dating ano, yung mga halagang 40 lang.
Mas matlaki pa rin yung increase kaysa sa rollback. Mas mabagal na rollback.
The government is not sure if the downward trend in fuel prices will continue in the next weeks.
In a day, nagtataas-baba ang presyo. So hindi natin malaman kung magsusustain siya.
The actual rollback is lower than the estimates of the Energy Department as oil companies cite premium costs and higher fuel additive, which tempered the reduction. Consumer group Laban Consumer says the DOE should call the attention of oil companies that just copy the rollback advisory of the industry's price leader.
How can market premium be the same amount for 30 or so importers and traders? Kopyahan lang hanggang ngayon, nagkokopyahan. Oh. Dapat na mataas pa yung rollback. Ngayon sinabi hindi pwede kasi may in-apply na market premium. Ang dami nilang dahilan. Ang dami nilang dahilan na hindi dapat ipasa sa ating mga consumers.
Taga may premium lahat dahil pare-pareho ng produkto eh. Diba? Homogeneous naman. Walang iba. Isa lang yan. Kung gasolina yan, gasolina. Kung yung pagkakabili ng isang oil company, may premium din yung susunod.
For the first quarter of 2022, diesel prices have already increased by almost 28 pesos per liter, 18.30 for gasoline, and more than 25 pesos for kerosene. That's why public utility drivers are appealing for the release of the government's fuel subsidy.
Sana bigay na nila yung subsidy. Pandagdag din yun sa ano, tuition ng mga anak ko.
Mula simula yung pandemic, hindi ako nakatanggap eh. Sana mabigyan naman kami ng kahit kunting ayuda.
But the LTFRB says the fuel subsidy is temporarily suspended as it awaits the decision of the COMELEC to exempt the program from the ban on disbursements.
In-assure din natin yung COMELEC na pag pinagbigyan tayong magpatuloy ng distribution, it will not be used for political gains. So currently po, ang LTFRB ay nag-aantay sa desisyon ng COMELEC.
Senator Grace Poe urges the COMELEC to expedite its decision on the LTFRB's request for exemption. The poll body says the decision will be out this week.
Pinag-submit namin ng mga ebidensya ang LTFRB at pinag-submit namin ang tinatawag na position paper or memorandum at yun po ay na-comply na po nila. Ito po ay kasalukuyan ang nag-undergo noong study and therefore Miyerkules po may masasubmit po na recommendation sa NBank at i-expect nyo po hanggang Thursday ay may announce na po natin yung action ng COMELEC patungkol po sa request po ng LTFRB.
More than 100,000 jeepney and bus drivers have received 6,500 pesos in fuel subsidy, but taxi and delivery riders have yet to obtain help. The list of eligible tricycle drivers in various LGUs has yet to be submitted by the DALG. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.
Here at home, Philippine inflation rose as expected in March on the back of high fuel prices. After staying flat at 3% in February, consumer prices accelerated to 4% last month. Food and non-alcoholic beverages, utilities, and transport contributed the most to overall inflation. The March print brings the national average to 3.4%, well within the Philippine Central Bank's 2 to 4% target range for 2022. But the bank says that target could be breached given the surging prices of oil globally. They add that the war in Russia and Ukraine will continue to roil global markets and that this will, in turn, bring about higher oil prices in the Philippines. And at least one economist warns that Philippine inflation could rise by as much as 5%.
We haven't seen the end of the oil price fluctuations, and depending on how bad it could get in the Ukraine and the disruption in the oil supply, I think we're in for a much bigger oil price hikes in the next few weeks. If nothing else is done, it could go up as much as 4.5% to even 5%. Mm-hmm. And I think this is the proof that if we don't manage the oil price hikes, it will have a multiplier effect and it will really worsen inflation in the country. Mm-hmm.
The BSP, however, assures the public that they have a wide arsenal of policy instruments to respond to these possible external shocks. They also urge the government to continue rolling out non-monetary measures to mitigate the impact of the conflict between Russia and Ukraine. The wage board in Metro Manila dismisses a labor group's petition for a 470 peso wage hike. The Trade Union Congress of the Philippines early asked for the wage hike, which would be given to everyone regardless of their salary level, as the prices of basic goods increase. But the wage board says an across-the-board wage hike was outside of their authority.
They actually listened to ECOP, the employers group, saying it is without jurisdiction. What we did, although we do not agree with what they have already said, because for us it's misapplication or misinterpretation of the facts of the Metrobank case, kami pa. But then again, what we did this afternoon, we refiled our petition. Para, you know, sabi naman ni Presidente Digong na we are in a state of emergency, at the same time, sinasabi naman ni Bello na kailangan na talagang increase ng NCR.
The TUCP has also asked for a 430 peso wage hike in the Central Visayas and for the minimum wage in the Davao region to be raised to 814 pesos. Labor Secretary Sylvester Bello III earlier ordered regional wage boards to speed up the review of minimum wages due to the fuel price increases.